So you're running the mile or the 3K?
I'm doing the mile.
Wow.
Yeah.
So what are your thoughts on the mile?
I was just saying, I have actually run faster in the steeplechase now than I have in the flat 3K. So I really should probably be in the 3K just because I need to fix that. But I just don't really like the flat 3K very much. I'd rather be jumping over stuff. And I love the mile. I've run it a few times in college really well, and I just have like good memories of the mile. And it's way more fun. You just get to run fast, and like before you realize it, it's over.
Have you done races this winter?
That happens. It'll be my opener since I raced. One of my last races actually in New York City at the 5th Ave Mile, and I got injured kind of all fall, and spent the last month at altitude training with the team in Colorado Springs. And so everyone's opening up this weekend.
We do USAs?
Yeah. Well, I have to get I have the world standard, but I don't have the USA standard, so I have to run 4:28.5 tomorrow to get a qualifying mark for USAs.
So you're how do you have the world standard from outdoor?
It's a different time period.
So ridiculous.
I know. Yeah.
What do you think you can do tomorrow?
We'll see. Kate and I, like I said, have been injured in the fall, and I went to Dallas to the team June 1st. We were there for a month, so put in a lot of good work. Kate and I have been running a workout side by side. She's super speedy, and she's actually won this event before. So
she's actually what?
She's won this event before. She's won the mile before. So I've never been here before. I'm just excited to see what I can do and hopefully get close to my PR at the front. Last year I ran 4:24 at U with Shelby Hill, and her and I had a great meet there last year. So hopefully I can get down close to that mark. But really I just like want to compete, and it's a huge field, a really good field. Just putting myself in the mix and being able to see what I can do in the last like 400.
And having Kate join the group, you know, you got this little speedster. Has it been good for the group, and does she fit in well?
Amazing, yeah. Kate and Marielle Hall both joined us this fall. So we're up to like 9 women now, which is incredible. And they've both been amazing, both athletically and just personality-wise, amazing fit into the group. Both of them have really good work ethic where they just sign up for the workouts. They're like, yep, let's do it. Like, give it my all. And sometimes, you know, we all blow up. Sometimes a couple of us blow up. Sometimes we all have a great day, and it's all over the place because we have such a big group now. But, they both have really good attitudes about it, and everyone has been working together as a group.
And you guys usually go to Colorado Springs, or is that...
That's first time for us, actually. First time for me. Some of the older members have been there before. Usually this month we spend in Flagstaff, but this year we decided to try. It's an off year, so we decided to just try out something new, a different location, to see how it goes. And it was awesome. We were training at the training center every day, running Santa Fe Trail, and using the Air Force track, and it's up at 7,000 feet, so that was a new challenge for us running that high. But it was a great month that everyone had. It went by really fast, which is...
So Colorado Springs is 7,000 feet?
The Air Force track is at 7,000. Colorado Springs is at like 6,000, I believe.
How interesting. So
Air Force is even higher. Wow. But we were staying actually in Woodland Park, which is at like 8,500 feet. So we're staying even higher.
8,000.
About
so you guys weren't at the training center, you just go down there?
Yeah, we didn't stay at the training center.
Would you do anything there, or like rehab?
Yeah. They have all their medical facility stuff there, all the treatment, and then they have a beautiful weight room, strength and conditioning facility that we used.
So that's what you mean they used there was weights, or what?
Yeah, we did our weights there 3 days a week, and then got treatment there, ice baths, we can eat there if we wanted, they have a great cafeteria, and then they have a 50-meter pool that I was using, the fixed size pool for swimming and aqua jogging, so that was amazing just to be able to use those facilities, have full access, and feel so like that was our kind of home base, and then sleeping up in Woodland Park.
What was the injury you had?
I dealt with a few different things, mostly just like hamstring, hip problems that led to a foot problem, like a plantar thing, and like I had a bone bruise on my calcaneus, my heel bone, so I had to let that heal fully for like 6 weeks. Pretty much all there. I'm still swimming now, in addition to my running, but pretty much all there.
Swimming or aqua jogging?
Swimming.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
You like swimming?
Plug for my website. I wrote all about it.
Okay.
On Quigley.org.
All right, we'll check it out. I hate swimming. You can't talk to anybody, really.
I learned to love it.
Like, how much will you swim?
I hated it at first. Like, earlier this week, I swam 2 miles on Monday.
What?
3,000 meters on Wednesday.
You're not running very much?
I'm running 60 to 65 miles a week.
That's a decent amount.
About 4 hours, 3 to 4 hours of swimming, and then, like, 60 to 65 miles of running.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
I'll have to read the blog post.
It's actually fun. Yeah, runner turned mermaid.
Wow. Triathlon for you?
Maybe, I don't know. Not really. I'm not that good. I like it because I work really hard, and it doesn't wear me out the way the running does. It doesn't put, like, junk in my legs the way the running does. Like, I can swim 3,000 meters and the next day, wake up, and still have a great run. I don't feel, like, zonked or, like, my legs are trashed from the swim.
How fast do you swim a mile?
Like, on Monday, I swam 2 miles in 59 minutes, so just under
30 minutes a mile.
Not bad for a runner.
I have no idea what's good.
Okay.
All right, thanks.
Thank you.